Yeah, over the last 4 years, we've had hard numbers. It may have been a trend before that, but as you say, over the last 4 years, a 22% increase for men, 93% increase for women.
That's huge, and, by the way, 93%. You never hear about that much of a increase in anything.
Right. Well, you know, I think what's fortunately it's happening because my research convinces me that it's particularly women and poor blacks who live in high crime urban areas, the people who are most likely to be victims of violent crime, who benefit the most from having the option to be able to go and protect themselves. In the case of women, women are relatively weaker physically. You're almost always talking about a male criminal doing the attack, whether it's a male attacking a female or a male attacking a male. There's a lot larger strength differential that exists there on average when a man is attacking a woman, particularly young males that you have doing the attack.
Right.
And so, you know, and I think part of this is due to some of the changing rules for getting permits. So, for example, in Texas, just 5 years ago, you only had about 500,000 concealed carry permit holders. Now it's over 1.2 million. But a lot of that change is due to changing rules. It used to be 10 hours of training to get the permit, 10 hours to renew it. That was pretty costly. Now it's 4 hours. And you see a lot more minorities getting permits, being able to afford it. Texas this year now has just lowered its fee from $140 to get a permit to $40. And my guess is you're going to see relatively more poor minorities going and getting permits now than you did before.
Right.